The first test was with a 400 watt from Dido here, HMI, and I use this lens before because I know it. If you put this lens on, you get much more light for the spot position. This inside the cave, you can imagine how big it is here. This stalagmite is 10 meters and all is covered with ice, and you have to walk this special attachment to the shoes, otherwise it's too slippery. I was happy that you can mount the ballast at the stand so it's free of water. And this snow hill gives the name of this cave. It's called Eisvulkan in German. And here you can see we use a Panaura for the fill light to light up the cave. And this is the 400 with an attachment, and we light these pictures, the sculptures of the ice there. So, as you can see, my name is Achim Donka, and I work as a teacher and filmmaker and also as an author. A student of mine asked me, how should we light an ice cave? He's a climber. I think he's one of the world leading ice climbers. He's sponsored by Black Diamond, and you have to be very good if you are sponsored by such a company. He asked me, how should I do this? And I've said to him, oh, I worked, when I was a young man, I worked in a coal mine, and this was very dark there, but I have no experience in an ice cave. And his question was, how can I use a balloon light? I've said to him, no, I've never worked before, but I think it sounds interesting, and so let me do it for you, and I will test it. So, and the first test was with a 400 watt from Dido here, HMI, and I use this lens before because I know it. If you put this lens on, you get much more light, as we heard yesterday and today, for the spot position. So, and I place this lamp with the lens 100 meters before our house, and I measured it, and I said, okay, I can give you a 2.8 in the cave, maybe it will be enough. So, and the other things I checked at this time was, will the lamp work with, I have a cable with more than 100 meters, so it's enough. Okay, so it was a TV production. And for Servus TV, I think it's an Austrian TV station for mountain and all this stuff. So, and we walk into two caves and four seams. The first was a historical ice ring and historical cave research and current cave research and ice climbing. So this is not my normal space for living. I'm not a highlander, I'm a flatlander. As you can imagine, so, and they are up to 1,500 meters, and this was the first cave. It's open to the public, but after the tour with the cable car, so it was 1,000-meter foot march with heavy stuff, and the second one was only you can get there by helicopter, but it was a rough terrain, so it's for me very, scary about to walk that. The equipment, we have one generator with only 2 kW, so that's why I should say to this presentation to light up Gothic Cathedral or a cathedral like the Peter's Church in Rome with only 2 kW. So it's and we use the Panaura 5 and 2 400 with this parallel beam attachment and some little stuff there. So. Also a little, let's say like 8 watt. So, and we bring it there with a big pack, so by helicopter. So, this was our generator here. And so it's a style that Philip preferred, your small green one. So, and this is the entrance, this is snow here, so. And this was down there 30 meters. It was very scary for me to work. This inside the cave, you can imagine how big it is here. This stalagmite is 10 meters. And this is Valerie, she's a production manager, and you can see it's more than 50 meters here. So, and all is covered with ice, and you have to walk this special attachment to the shoes, otherwise it's too slippery. And it's a little bit melting here, so in I was happy that you can mount the ballast at the stand so it's free of water. So, and this snow hill gives the name of this cave. It's called Eisvulkan in German. If you Google it, you will find some pictures. It's 50 meters here. It's open to a chimney, 20 meters, and the snow came down. And during wintertime, everything is freezing here, but it's don't melt away in summertime. So it's... And the distance from here is, I think, 60 meters over there. So, and it was a two-day shooting, and we slept outside in front of the cave, like a Boy Scout camp. He's the cameraman. This is my eldest son, so. And here you can see we use a panara for the phyllite to light up the cave. And this is the 400 with an attachment, and we light these pictures, the sculptures of the ice there. This thing is also 8 meters high. So this is a different cave. It's open to the public. This is also ice. It's here. This is the attachment. And also, you know this stuff. So here you can see the ice sculptures in the wall. This is here you can see this is one of the guys who climbed up there, like him here. So this is, I think, was 50 meters here. This was a cameraman. So we prepared. We made the shooting for people who sit on a sofa and look to the TV and say, wow, that looks looking great. So it's in their mind, the ice is blue. Later on, I will take a little bit about my lighting concept. So, and it's very bright in this situation. 1 pound hour, you can imagine, because it's absolutely dark in this. So when you will see how bright this kind of lamps are. So, and we use also this lamp for close-ups. So, this is historical cave research, and these are old-fashioned dressed. Cave researchers, so it's for exploring. They use carbide lamps, and it's very yellow lamps. So I think the idea was to shoot it on daylight, and this part of we light it up with tungsten. And for the eyes, I use this daylight combined with CTB, so it becomes very, very blue, you know. So it looks like a circus a little bit, you know, like show lighting. But the cameraman, he was absolutely crazy about it. He loves it. So this is also one. Here also, we light the eyes from behind with blue. And here you can see these carbide lamps. So, and in the beginning of the century, there was a cave near Salzburg. And the people there use it as an historical ice rink or as an ice stadium for ice skating there. But it was not so comfortable to get there. And as the entrance was very small, and they use a little bit dynamite to make it bigger, the problem was after that it's come too much warm air inside in the cave, and it's gone, you know. So, and in old books you can see there is a frozen waterfall there. This is a nice picture we use for the foreground panaura and some rim light with blue. And for the wall, I think it was nearly 50 meters there, we use only the Letzilla 8 watt. So you can combine this, or it's possible this panaura with 8 watt of Letzilla. So it gives you. But if you count this on the lamp, so we have only 1600 watts. And so I said, well, that's great. If you know, if we work with this crazy guy, they work the whole day without break, and the other stuff is boring for them. And said, okay, I've 400 watts, so I buy a traveling water cooker. So we have our own coffee during this time. So, okay, that's it.